Good morning and welcome to Beginning the Day with God on Friday the 21st of June. We opened our worship this morning with a piece of music by Alexis French entitled Forgiven. O God, our Creator, your kindness has brought us the gift of a new morning. Help us to leave yesterday and not to covet tomorrow, but to accept the uniqueness of today.
By your love, celebrated in your word, seen in your Son, brought near by your Spirit, take from us what we need to carry no longer, so that we may be free again to choose to serve you and to be served by each other.
Amen. And now, this morning's reading. Continuing our journey through Luke's Gospel, chapter 17, verses 1 to 10. Jesus said to his disciples, "Occasions for stumbling are bound to come, but woe to anyone by whom they come. It would be better for you if a millstone were hung around your neck and you were thrown into the sea, than for you to cause one of these little ones to stumble. Be on your guard. If another disciple sins, you must rebuke the offender. And if there is repentance, you must forgive. And if the same person sins against you seven times a day and turns back to you seven times and says, 'I repent,' you must forgive." The apostle said to the Lord, "Increase our faith." The Lord replied, "If you had faith the size of a mustard seed, you could say to this mulberry tree, 'Be uprooted and planted in the sea,' and it would obey you. Who among you would say to your slave who has just come in from ploughing or tending sheep in the field, 'Come here at once and take your place at the table'? Would you not rather say to him, 'Prepare supper for me, put on your apron and serve me while I eat and drink. Later, you may eat and drink.' Do you thank the slave for doing what was commanded? So you also, when you have done all that you were ordered to do, say, 'We are worthless slaves. We have done only what we ought to have done.'" Thanks be to God. Now our reflection.
Occasions for sin scarcely covers it. The Greek word is skandalon, which first meant a trap and later came to mean a stumbling block. It is the root of our word scandal. We cannot read this without thinking of the enormous scandal in every sense of that word, of child abuse hurting these little ones. It's a scandal made worse when it is clerical abuse, when the very people whose role is to guard and protect have themselves become predators. Jesus does not mince his words in pronouncing this woe. It is such a grievous thing to become the scandalon, the cause of calamity and wounding, the destroyer of faith in another, that it would be better to have been cast into the sea. But notwithstanding these harrowing words of warning, the church that works in Jesus' name has allowed such things to happen so many times over that not only are the victims hurt, but also all those who love them and the wider society, rightly scandalized, are losing trust in the church and even faith in God. And still, in spite of everything, Christ keeps covenant with us and will not let us go or cast us off, neither the sinner nor the sinned against. What is to become of those whom he said should be cast into the sea with a millstone around their necks? Only the one who took Jonah on his only sign can answer that. Amen.
We now join together in the Lord's Prayer, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, we thank you that you have brought us safely to the beginning of this day. Keep us from falling into sin or running into danger. Order us in all our doings, and guide us to do always what is righteous in your sight. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil, and keep us in eternal life.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.